Good morning, children. Welcome back to online classes. So, children, previous class we have discussed about our basic need clothes. Yana children, we discussed people in different parts of India have their special clothes. Each country has its the special costumes. And I have given the one activity also. Have you done that activity, children? Yes. If you done this, then send me in the app. So, children, today we'll see the we have the some other different clothes to wear for the different occasions. We also have the different clothes for different occasions. So, what is the next here? Today we discussed about the different clothes for different occasions. Different clothes for different occasion. Occasion means what? Either it is marriage, party, or opening ceremony, birthday party, anything. Okay, children? Occasions. Special day. So, today we see the different clothes for different occasions. Yeah, the children, when you go for party, then your party dress is a party cloth is a different only. Which clothes you will wear in home? The same cloth you doesn't wear it in for party. You will change it. Then the children, you will wear the long frock, or you will wear, your mother will wear the border saree, your father will wear the suit, you know. Then coat, tie, everything you will wear. Yes, that means what here? Party dresses are different only. Daily use dresses we doesn't wear for the party. Yeah, the children, when you participate in the sports, then the sports wear, sports dresses are different only. Yes or no? Yes, you will wear the one cap. If you are playing the cricket match, then you will wear the white shirt, white pant, one cap. If you are participating in the football, then you will wear the t-shirt and the half pant, and then shoes, sports shoes and socks you will wear it. Yes or no? If you are skating, if you are a hockey, badminton player, then the for all the events there is are different clothes are there. So that we say the sports wear, sports clothes is a different. In that frock, sari, and then mini skirt, jeans pant, you can participate in the sports. You can't run, you can't play the any game because the dresses are different. Yes or no? Yes. Like that in the swimming costume we say. In the swimming also, when you are practicing the swimming, you will wear the different kinds of the clothes. For night dress also, whatever you wear full day, that dress you won't wear in the night. Again, you will change it. Yeah, so let me show that all the images, which clothes you will wear in the party and the sports. Just to see, children, here. So, these clothes are called the party clothes. See, a frock and the necklace, heel shoes, tie, suit, trouser, you know, so everything you will wear for the party, you will get up ready, very beautiful. Yes or no? Yes. The next you can see the sports wear. See the dresses. See all the dresses are different only. You know, you will use for the different games for different dresses. See your cap, helmet. This you will use for cricket. Then this is for running. This is for skating. Then you will use also shoes, sports shoes you will wear, sports socks you will wear. You know, the next like that only you can see the swimming costumes. You know, children, So these all the things you will wear when you are doing the swimming. See, the dresses is different. The next, the night dress when you are sleeping, again the your dressing style is changed. You will wear the gown, otherwise you will wear the 3/4 or half pant or banyan. Any children? Otherwise you will wear the gown. See, the night gown, it is called the night gown. So these all are the varieties of cloths you will wear for the different occasion. Party cloths, sports cloths, swimming costumes, or we say the swimming wear and the night dresses. Yeah, no children? When you come to school, you can see here the uniform is the change. And your uniform is changed to the other school. It's not the same. It is a different only. You know, whatever you will wear in the home, that night dress, frock, that same clothes you will wear for the school? No. For the school, there is a uniform. So you will wear the uniform, shirt, half pant, skirt, tie, belt, hairband, ribbon, shoes, socks. Complete uniform you will wear to school. You know, children, see the dressing style is a change. So, your uniform is which color? Tell me, children. Yes, your uniform is cream color shirt and the brown color pant or skirt. You have the one tie, one belt, black shoes, and white and brown color socks. So this is the your uniform you will wear and come to school. So like that, other people also wear the uniform. So this sari is uniform for teachers. It is my uniform. I should wear this sari. I should wear this uniform and come to school. So like that, postman have the uniform. Then policeman also have the uniform, doctor, nurse, soldier, and the pilot. All the people who will do the different job. So the all the people wear the different kinds of uniform. It is not the same. These all uniforms are different to each other. When you go to the hospital, you can see the doctors wear the white shirt and the pant. You know, that means the uniform is a change. You can see this person. Who is this? Yes, he is a soldier. See the soldier costume. It is a change only. This person is who? He is a postman. You can see the postman costume. Brown color pant and shirt, then one bag with that full of letters. Next one is who? Next is the nurse. See the nurse costume, dress, say it is changed only. Full white cap, then white uniform, white socks and white shoes. Next one is the policeman. That see the dress, again it is changed. Then last one is the who here? Pilot. You can see the pilot uniform is changed. Navy blue pant and the sky blue color shirt, very light color. So these all, if you see these all the images, they all are different to each other. You know, see the uniforms also different only. Yes or no? Yes. So these are uniforms for these peoples. So these are the different kinds of clothes for different occasions, and who are doing the job for them also it is a different only. Why we are wearing the uniform? To recognize that person, that student is belongs to our school only. How we will observe it? By seeing the uniform. If you see that one man is standing, when you see see the uniform. Yes, that person is a traffic policeman. How you will come to know? Because he is wearing the uniform. When you go to hospital, when you see the one man is saying one boy, how you will come to know that person only is a doctor by saying his uniform? Yes or no? So there is other people, they will wear the uniforms. Soldiers' uniform is different only. Yes, so here, who will do the job for all the people have the uniform. Yeah, the children. So we'll see. This is the, we discussed about the different kinds of the cloth for different occasions. So how this cloth will made? Now we'll see the next topic. What is that? The cloth is made from fibers. How it is made? Made from fibers or thread. Cloths is made from fibers or thread. So materials for cloth, it comes from different source only. Whatever cloth we will wear, it's made from the fibers and thread, and that material it's come from the different source only. If you see the cotton dresses, how the cotton dresses is made up of? It is the help of the cotton only. Cotton means what, children? This is the cotton plant. White color cotton. So the cotton cloths is made up of cotton only. Cotton plant. So cotton cloth is made up of the cotton cloth. We can see the, when the summer comes, you will start to wear the cotton cloths only. And that cotton cloths is made up of the cotton plant. Rui is in a white color, rui. Yes, that is called the cotton plant. Let me show the one image, then you will understand. See here, children, this is the cotton plant. This white color, you can see, no, it's a cotton. So cotton cloth is made up of cotton only. Yes. So like that, there is a jute also is there. Jute cloth, you say jute. Now you will think, what is the meaning of jute? Jute andre na sutadi, sutadi inda tayar aagiruva vastu. Jute. Nowadays you can see the jute bag, tiffin bags, you know, vanity bags, jute bag only. Later I will show the images, then you will understand what is the meaning of the jute. Nylon cloths. So like that, this all the things we will get from the plants only. Like that we have the another kind of the cloths also, materials that we get from animals. So animals we get from the wool. With that silkworm we will get the silk. Silk materials. We are wearing the silk sari, silk frock. That we get from the silkworm only. Later I will show the all the images. Then you will understand how this cloth is made up of. Okay children. Here I will show some images. See here, this is called the silkworm. It's not clear, I will show the later. And wool we will get from the sheep only. Okay children, so here you can see this is the cotton plant. So with the help of this cotton only, we will make the cotton cloths. You can see here.
So this is a jute. Sutradi you say no in Kannada. See the jute bag. Cloth. This is called the jute. Next, you can see the linen cloths. So next is the woolen cloths we get from sheep. See here sweater, scarf, so these are all the cloths made up of wool only. This woolen cloths you will wear in winter season. When you are feeling cold, you will wear these cloths. Next is the silk cloths. Silk cloth we will get from silkworm only. See here. It's a silkworm. See the silk. So these are the silkworm. See the silk sari. Next you see children, we also have man-made fibers made in factories. Polyester. See the t-shirt. These all are polyester cloths. Next is rayon cloths. These all made in factories. Next you can see the terry linen cloths. So children, just now I have shown us some images of different kinds of cloths. Yeah, children, some cloths we will get from the nature only. That is called the natural fiber. So here jute, cotton, and then linen, wool, and the silk. These are called the natural fibers. What is called? It's called the natural fibers. We get from the plants and animals. Yeah, children, this year see, this all the three, jute, cotton and linen, we will get from
from the plants, and the wool and silk we will get from the animal. Then, see, the wool we will get from the sheep, and the silk we will get from the silkworm insects. Clear, children? So these are the natural fibers. And the next I have shown the which we also have man-made fibers, that is made in factories, like t-shirt, we say the polyester, rayon, you know, terenine, then nylon, it is the made in factories. Those are called the man-made fibers. What is that man-made fibers, children, here? What is that? Tell me here, man-made fibers. Polyester. Yes. Then next one is the rayon. Yes. Then nylon. Yes. Then next one is the terrine, or we see the terrylene. So these all four are the man-made fibers. What is that? It is a man-made fibers. This man-made fibers made in factories. You know, children? So these are the different types of the cloth is made from fibers or thread. Thread means what? Dara. You know, children? So these are, see here, we have the polyester, rayon, nylon, terrine, that is the man-made fibers, and the natural fibers, jute, cotton, linen, wool and silk is the natural fibers. This we get from the nature, animals and the insect, and this here the we are getting ready made from the factories. Okay, children? So Gandhiji also made a fabric by hand, that is khadi, fabric by hand only. He used that charka and he made with hand. And with that thread he made the khadi cloth, khadi batte, you know. So we have to think that now we got the materials, how the peoples give the shape of that cloth. When you go to shop, you will purchase the piece of clothes, either it is shirt, pant, sari or anything. So what you will do, you will purchase that piece of clothes and you will go to tailor. You will go to tailor to stitch that cloth. You know? To stitch that cloth, you will go to tailor shop. What the tailor do? He stitch the cloth as we want, then stitch. Either we want chudidar, or we want the frock, we want the midi, skirt, shirt, pant, anything. He will stitch for us. He will give the shape for that design, for that cloth, how we want. And the children, the weaver weaves the cloths out of fiber. So with that thread and fiber, here weavers, he made the cloths. He will join that all the things you can see here, weaver. See how is the weaver view the cloths. You can see here how he is using that all. This is a machine. Means what it is, with that help of this machine only he is weaving the cloths. So weaver view the cloths out of fibers. Okay, children? And then what the tailor do? Tailor stitch our cloth. See here. Tailor stitch our cloth how we want. You know, children? Yes. So we always wear this all. dirty and the uniron cloths. Always we will wear the neat, clean and iron cloths only. We must wear the cloths that are comfortable and fit well. Should not, if you are very thin, should not wear the cloth too much, double size of your body only. That should be comfort and it is a fit well. Clear, children? So we must wear the cloths to suit the weather. If there is a summer, we should wear the cotton cloth. If there is a winter, we should wear the woolen cloth. So we should wear the cloth to suit the winter. Clear, children? We should not wear the cloth if it is rainy or the summer. We should not wear the summer season cotton cloth. If there is a rainy, we should not wear the cotton cloths. In summer, cotton only, and in winter and rainy, we should wear the woolen cloths only. Clear, children? That means what here? That cloth is suit to that weather. Clear, children? So this is about the cloths. Today we discussed about the cloth is made from fibers or thread. Okay, children? So this lesson I finished. And now I will give the homework, whatever I have explained in this video. Okay, children? So one activity first I will give for you. The activity what means, you have to collect the different kinds of cloths. Either it is jute, cotton, nylon, silk, anything. Collect and then cut the pieces of that cloth and then stick in your notebook, or you can make a chart. Okay, children? So homework, what is that? Stick the fabric. You get in your home. So stick the fabrics you get in your home. Either it is the woolen, silk, cotton. Stick that. I will write that names, then it is easy for you. Cotton. Cut the small square piece only. Cut the small square piece and then stick in your notebook. Then one more. You will get easy way. That only I will give. Wool. I will write woolen cloth. Take the two or three threads of woolen and then stick it here. Okay, children. Then next one is the silk. You will get the silk also, no? Yes. So this three is enough. Then silk. The next is what? I will give one more. That is the jute. So what you have to do? Cut the small pieces of these all the fabrics and stick here and then send me in the app. So this is the homework for you. It is a homework and activity. This activity is homework for you. You have to write the lesson name, our basic needs cloth, then write the homework, stick the fabrics you get in your home. That is the cotton. Cut the cotton, woolen, silk and jute. Don't cut the new saree and new frock. This for to do this activity, children, take the help of your parents. Okay, children? So this activity do in your home in the EVS notebook and then send me in the app. So I have finished the basic needs unit only. So we have the three basic needs, that is the air, water and the finally it is a cloth. Clear, children? So this work you have to do in the ABS notebook and then send me in the app folder. So this is our today's class. I hope you will enjoy it.